Okay, so now you can see today our topic of discussion related to stereochemistry once again, right? So first of all, you people can see here our discussion related to stereoisomers and stereochemistry. So as we already know, the most important point in stereochemistry, that is about either our compound is optical active or not, right? So this is our very important point. Either our compound is optically active or not, right? So what are the point? Based on that, we can say our compound is optical active or not. So you know, you can see here, right? Rotate plane of polarized light, right? So if our compound rotate plane of polarized light, if our compound rotate plane of polarized light, right? So then that is called the compound is optically, then we can say the compound is optically active, right? So if compound rotate plane of polarized light, right? Then that compound is called optical active compound. Then that compound is called optical active compound. Now, what is basic requirement according to our old concept, right? So chirality. The compound should be chiral, right? Chirality is very important point. The carbon where four different group is called chiral carbon, right? If at least one chiral center exists in a molecule, then they can rotate plane of polarized light, as you already know, right? And then that is called enantiomer. Then that is called enantiomer because if they rotate plane of polarized light in right hand direction, then their mirror image rotate plane of polarized light in left hand direction, right? So one is dextrorotary and second is levorotary. You people already know two types of enantiomer. One is dextrorotary and second is levorotary. Now the point come, what do you mean by polarized light? So you can see here, right? This is unpolarized light. This is unpolarized light and this is polarized light, right? This is called polarized light, right? Unpolarized light means the light which is vibrate in all direction. The light which vibrate in all direction, that is called unpolarized light. And if the light vibrate in only one direction, you can see here, if the light vibrate only one direction, then that is called polarized light, right? You know, now the point come, right? If this is white light means it is unpolarized light. If white polarized light and that which vibrate in all direction, pass through Nicole prism, polarizer, which is called polarizer or Nicole prism, right? So when this light or unpolarized light pass through Nicole prism, right, then they convert into unpolarized light. Unpolarized light convert into polarized light if they pass through Nicole prism, right? So this is called polarization of light. This is called polarization of light. So either our compound is optically active or optically inactive. It is clear with help of polarized light, right? Because if our compound rotate plane of polarized light either in right hand direction or left hand direction, then that is called optical active compound, right? Then that is called optical active compound. But before that, we should clear what about the polarized or plane of polarized light, right? So this is unpolarized light, which vibrate in all direction. When they pass through Nicole prism, then they convert into plane of polarized light, right? And then if that plane of polarized light, right, interact with our compound, this is our compound, right? When that plane of polarized light pass through the solution of our chiral or our optical active compound, right? You can see this compound is optical active. Why we call this compound is optical active? Because, you know, if center suppose that carbon, then one color is red, second color is green, yellow, and you can see, right, blue color. So in this way, four different color, it means four different types of groups or atom exist at center carbon. It means this carbon is chiral carbon. And if the carbon is chiral carbon, then they can rotate plane of polarized light. Either in right-hand direction or in left-hand direction. For example, you can see here, right? This is plane of polarized light. You can see right? And when they pass through this solution, then they rotate, right? Right hand direction. You can see they rotate at a certain angle in a right hand direction, right? So it means this compound is called optically active compound. This compound is called optically active compound because rotation of plane of polarized, because this compound rotate plane of polarized light, right? What about the angle? You can see this angle may be alpha. This is called optical angle, right? This is called optical angle, right? And the term optical angle or angle of rotation or specific rotation, this is very important, right? So what about the angle? This is the angle alpha, right? And the angle alpha depend on concentration of solution. It means if the number of optical active molecule increase in our solution, then the angle will increase, right? And when the number of molecules of optical active compound decrease in solution, then the angle will decrease, right? So this angle is totally depend on number of optical active molecules exist in our solution, right? So when these number of molecule increase, then the angle size also increase. And when the number of these molecule decrease, then the angle size decrease, right? This is about angle of rotation, which is directly proportional to concentration of optical active compound exists in our solution, right? Or in our path, right? If suppose that this is our path, right? From which our light pass through, right? So then, right? If the length of path increase, it means the number of molecules increase in that path, right? And then the angle of light will increase, right? Now the point come specific rotation. Specific rotation, it is constant value, right? Angle of rotation is not constant value, right? Angle of rotation is not constant value because, as I already told, it depends on C, concentration of optical active molecule. It depends on concentration of optical active molecule. And second point, as I already told, that is about bond length, right? That also depends on bond length, right? What about the bond length, right? First point, that depends on bond length. And second point, that depends on length of path, right? So C and L, right? If we change C and L, then the value of alpha also change. It means angle of rotation depend on concentration of solution and path length, right? But if you want specific rotation actually is specific or constant for every optical active compound, right? It will not change when we increase concentration of solution, right? So when we change concentration of solution, then the specific rotation will be not changed. It is specific for a specific compound, right? And how do we denote that? You can see alpha within bracket equal to 100 alpha upon C L, because concentration, if unit and the path length also unit, right? Then the specific rotation is a constant value for our optical active compound. For our optical active compound, concentration, gram per 100 ml, right? And length of path in decimeter, right? So this is unit for concentration and path length, right? And this is formula for specific angle of rotation, right? And this is angle of rotation, or is it specific rotation, right? It is constant for specific compound. So it should be clear. Now racemic mixture, you people already know, right? So that mixture, right, where 50% dextrorotatory and 50% levorotary enantiomers. You know enantiomers means? Enantiomers actually optical active compound. You people already know enantiomers are actually optical active compound where at least one chiral carbon and they rotate plane of polarized light, right? So if they rotate plane of polarized light in right hand direction, you people already know, I have already discussed, right? So then that is called dextrorotary, right? And their mirror image, right? Their mirror image, because enantiomers are peer, right? They are mirror image of one another. One rotate plane of polarized light in right hand direction, other rotate plane of polarized light in left hand direction, right? And if 50% out of 100 molecule, if suppose that 50 molecule dextrorotary and 50 molecule levorotary, right? So 50% molecule rotate plane of polarized light in right hand direction and 50% molecule rotate plane of polarized light in left hand direction. So overall, that mixture cannot rotate plane of polarized light. Overall, that mixture cannot rotate plane of polarized light. It means this is optically inactive compound or mixture or composition, right? So racemic mixture is that mixture which cannot rotate plane of polarized light either in right hand direction or left hand direction, because 50% right and 50% left, right? So this is about racemic mixture, right? Optically inactive, right? Where angle of rotation is zero, where angle of rotation is zero, right? So this is important point also, either in a chiral substance or racemic mixture, right? So if chiral, then they rotate plane of polarized light, then there is a certain angle of rotation, right? But if our compound is achiral, right, or racemic mixture, then they cannot rotate plane of polarized light in any direction, right? And that is called optically inactive compound. Then that is called optically inactive compound. I have already discussed about chirality. You know, chirality means handiness, right? Because this concept started from hand, right? Because earlier, when originate stereochemistry, I already told, first time scientists think about their hand, why my left hand and right hand that are actually image of one another but not exactly same, right? Right-handed batsman and left-handed batsman, I already told, these two hands are mirror image of one another, but they cannot superimpose. You can see here, right? You can see if you think about your head also, right? So they are mirror image of one another. They are exactly mirror image of one another. They are exactly mirror, but they cannot superimpose to each other, right? They cannot superimpose to each other. So this types of, this is the nature of enantiomers, right? They are a mirror image of one another, but they are not superimposed mirror image. They are not superimposed to each other. But if you think about these two flasks, you can see these two flasks, right? They can superimpose to each other, right? They can completely overlap to each other. They can completely overlap to each other. They can superimpose to each other. So this type is called achiral objects, right? The chiral object and achiral object, you can see our hands are chiral object while the flask is achiral object, right? They cannot superimpose and they can superimpose. This is the point, right? Plane of symmetry, I have already discussed in my previous class. What about plane of symmetry, right? That point I have already discussed. But once again, plane of symmetry means two-part mirror, not identical mirror image, right? Cyclobutane, I have already discussed, right? So if 50%, if we bisect molecule in two part, right? As we discuss about tartaric acid, right? When we bisect molecule in two part, right? Two part are mirror of one another. They are not identical, actually. They are mirror image of one another, right? And when they are mirror image of one another, right? So then 50% rotate plane of polarized light in right hand direction and 50% rotate plane of polarized light. So that compound is mesio compound. We had already discussed in our previous class, right? And then the symmetry is called plane of symmetry. Then the symmetry is called plane of symmetry. We had already discussed in our previous class about cyclobutane, right? About cyclobutane, right? So this is, you can see here, C2, C3, C4. Now you can see this is compound, right? This types of compound, if suppose that this is cyclohexane, right? And here methyl group, and here also methyl group. If you bisect this molecule in two part, right? You can see if you bisect this molecule in two part, to upper part and lower part, both are exactly same. Upper part and lower part, both are exactly same, right? So this is called plane of symmetry. We had already discussed, right? This is not plane of symmetry, because here you can see OH, right? Here CN, here ME and ME, right? So it means it is optically inactive compound. It is optically inactive. This compound is optically inactive compound, right? And you can see, because OH and CN in one plane, right? ME right hand side and ME left hand side. So they are mirror image of one. They are mirror image of. So here also plane of symmetry. So this compound also show plane of symmetry because it is down the plane and it is above the plane. It means these two, right? If we take these two in plane, right? So then you can see, right? This types of condition. This is called plane of symmetry, right? Present plane of symmetry, CN, right? So this is the compound where they show plane of symmetry, right? Sigma plane symmetry, right? We had already discussed about sigma plane symmetry, right? So different four different group are attached. If there is four different group, you can see, right? This carbon here, CN, here OH, here H, and here CH2R, right? So this is chiral compound, right? This is chiral compound, and it is optically active compound, right? This is optically active compound because it is a chiral carbon. So you can see here, right? This is also optical active compound, but this compound is not optical. Above compound is not optical active, right? This is called sigma plane symmetry, yeah, plane of symmetric compound. Above compound is called plane of symmetric compound, right? Because OSCN or ME, two groups are exactly same. So there is a plane of symmetry. But if we focus on this, four groups are entirely different. This group, four groups are entirely different, right? So this is not there, no any types of plane of symmetry, right? And your compound is optically active. Right? Center of symmetry, we had already discussed. Center joined by any substitute, right? Then extended back. Even hydrogen also, right? So center of symmetry means center join. First of all, we take one center, right? Any substituent, right? Then extend back. You can see here, right? So this is here, this compound show center of symmetry, right? You can see cyclobutane, same. We have already discussed, right? So they are center of symmetry because if this is center, you can extend right hand side H, left hand side H, right? If you go in this direction, CSC. Then you go in this direction, CSC. If you go in this direction, COH, then if you go in this direction, COH, right? So 2,4 dimethoxy cyclobutane, 1,3 dicarboxylic acid. It is center of symmetric compound. I have already discussed. What about center of symmetry or plane of symmetry? Plane of symmetry means major compound. Center of symmetry means this types of compound, right? If you take one center, right? If you take one center and after that you go here, COH, and extend back, then COH, right? You go here, CSC, and extend back CSC, right? Here, H, and here, H, right? So then this types of compound is called center of symmetric compound. And you know, according to modern theory, not only chirality important, but also symmetry also important. Because mesio compound, that compound when fail our old theory, which is only focused on chiral carbon, that theory fail. Because mesio compound is that compound where two chiral carbon, but they cannot rotate plane of polarized light because of plane of symmetry, right? So same here also, right? This types of symmetry also, right? So this is called center of symmetry, right? And this compound also optically inactive, right? Now after that, you can see it is center, right? You can take this type, this compound also here, COH, right? Here in this direction, you can go COH. This direction you can go COH, right? So it means same group both side from center. If you go in this direction OH and if you come in this direction OH, right? So this compound also show center of symmetry. It means this compound also optically not active. Because of center of symmetry. Your next point come alternative axis of symmetry, because I had already discussed, right? Four types of symmetry. First one is called simple axis of symmetry. Second is called plane of symmetry. Third is called center of symmetry. And last one is called alternative axis of symmetry. You can see, right? If we rotate at 90 degree, it means S4 symmetry. I already told. If we talk about 160 rotation. Right, if we rotate anything at 160, then the thing is exactly same. Then that is called simple axis of symmetry. It exists in all compound. Right? Second case, you know about second case. What about second case? In second case, if we rotate compound at 180 degree, if we rotate compound at 180 degree and then, right, exactly same. then that is called plane of symmetry. If third one, right, center of symmetry, right, if we rotate that at 180, then we can go at 60, right? And then in this way, if we rotate that at 90 degree, right, so then that is called alternative axis of symmetry or S4 symmetry. You can see, right, we can take example because it will be clear with the help of example, alternative axis of symmetry, right? So if this is a compound, if suppose that this is our compound CH3, right, cyclobutane, right, here this CH3, right, down, then CH3 upper, then CH3 down, then CH3 upper, right? If you rotate that at 90 degree, then this point come here, then this point goes here, then this point goes here, and in this way you can see at this point, right, CH3 go down, then CH3 go up, then down, then up, then down, right? And after that, if you take their horizontal mirror image, if you take their horizontal mirror image, then you can see this CH3, this CH3, you can see this CH3, right? Then this CH3 at this point, right? Then this H goes upper side, right? HH upper side, then this HH upper side, CH3 down, then this CH3, because here it is down, right? So it is called upper side down, right? So this and this, these two are exactly same. So this types of symmetry is called alternative axis of symmetry. So if in our compound, alternative axis of symmetry also, that is not optically active compound, right? So if there is no optical active of symmetry, if there is no center of symmetry, if there is no plane of symmetry, then the compound will be optically active. Then the compound will be optically active, right? So this is the point, rotation 360, 2 pi means 360 upon n degree, right? Mirror image, parallel axis, 90 degree rotation, molecule 1, 2, 3, 4, right? That we had already discussed these points, right? Here, one other important point come, three symmetry should be, right? So at three symmetry should, if there is three symmetry, then the compound is not optically active. Either plane of symmetry, center of symmetry, or alternative axis of symmetry, then that compound is not optically active, right? You know, not any of these four symmetry, then asymmetric compound. Now the point, sometime, right, sometime examiner can ask you what is difference between asymmetric molecule and dissymmetric molecule, right? What is difference between asymmetric molecule and dissymmetric molecule? So asymmetric molecule means that molecule where not exist four symmetry, means there is no simple axis of symmetry, there is no plane of symmetry, there is no center of symmetry, and there is no alternative axis of symmetry, then that compound is called asymmetric molecule. Then that compound is called asymmetric molecule, and that compound is optically active, right? Dissymmetric. If a compound is dissymmetric, then that also optically active. If compound is dissymmetric, then that also optically active. Now the point come, what about dissymmetric molecule? Dissymmetric molecule means that molecule where simple axis of symmetry exists, but there is no plane of symmetry, there is no center of symmetry, and there is no alternative axis of symmetry, right? So if there is a simple axis of symmetry, but not center of symmetry, not mirror plane of symmetry, not alternative axis of symmetry, then that compound is called dissymmetric molecule. Then that compound is called dissymmetric molecule. And both asymmetric molecule and dissymmetric molecules are optically active. It means simple axis of symmetry. It means simple axis of symmetry is not important. Right, because maximum time, if we rotate anything or any material at 360 degree, then they are exactly same, right? So we ignore simple axis of symmetry. Right? We always focus on dissymmetric, or we always focus on rest-free symmetry, right? So in this way, you can see here, right? Mirror plane of symmetry, right? If we talk about plane of symmetry, right? So when we talk about plane of symmetry, it means it is about S1 symmetry. It is about S1 symmetry, right? If we talk about center of symmetry, it is denoted by I. mirror plane of symmetry you can see, mirror plane of symmetry you can see denoted by sigma. Center of symmetry you can see, it is denoted by I, right? And S4, that is alternative axis of symmetry, right? So when no plane of symmetry,